Hey everybody, this is John again. I just wanted to finish up with talking about stalking and hacking. I kind of had a lot of that discussed in part one. This is part two. And I just wanted to talk a little bit more about it. Of course, you can tell sometimes when you're being hacked. Obviously, your passwords are changed with your emails, your bank account, your credit card. It doesn't mean necessarily that they've stolen your money or they've used your credit card, but if your passwords are changed and you didn't change them, obviously you've been hacked. I mean, a lot of people on Facebook has had that happen too. So it's not uncommon sometimes for like Facebook being hacked, but if your credit card or your bank account or your emails have been changed, then that's pretty good indication that somebody might be personally targeting you. And what can you do about it? How can you tell other than that? That's a big sign that something's happening. But let's say that hasn't happened yet. What else can you do? Now, a lot of times what will happen is they will wiretap your phone. You know, they will listen to your calls. They will just keep a record, maybe even record what you're saying. Now, how can you tell that? You can always tell your phone is being hacked by a couple of things. One, the back and even the front of your phone will get really, really hot, and then the battery will start running down very quickly. And you can tell that. I mean, I've been on my phone for maybe an hour checking news stories or YouTube, and it's just as cold as ice, the phone. And the battery stays up high, but when it starts getting really hot, like I said, and the battery starts running down quickly, and you hear like cracking on the phone or the person when you're talking to someone, or they sound like they're in a well, those are real, all three of those, if they're happening at the same time, someone's listening to your phone call. That's just a given. What can you do about it? Absolutely nothing. Don't go and change your phone number. Don't go and change your phone, because if you do that, what's going to happen is they're going to then, that puts a target then on your friends, because they've already gone through your contact list and they probably already hacked into each one of your friends' phones and their pictures on their phone and everything else. You just have to understand, they're not just coming after you. They're going to check into every one of your friends, every one of your contacts, and they're going to stalk them, but without being noticeable about it. They're not going to change their passwords or do anything like that. They're just going to eavesdrop on the conversations, and that's how, in their phone records, and that's how they're going to get your number, your new phone number. So you might as well not waste your time. Don't change your phone number. Don't get a new phone. Nothing you can do is going to change them from hacking into your new phone and your new phone number. That's just a given. So just remember that you are being monitored, that someone is listening to your calls. If your phone is really hot, now another indication that your phone is being hacked is the location of where it's saying you're at. Now, how do you figure that out? You could type anything in, like Staples or AMC for the theater or something, and then see where it gives you the recommendations of where to go. Now, if it says, say you live in San Francisco like I do, but it's giving you locations in Los Angeles or Hawaii or Las Vegas, and then what you want to do is scroll all the way down to the bottom and it'll tell you where your location is. So if it says you're like hundreds of miles away or all the way across the state, you know, or across the nation, those are indication that someone is right at that time also hacking into your phone. Again, there's absolutely nothing you can do. You can block your locations. It's not going to work. They can still hack into your phone. So you just have to remember to be careful what you say, and let your friends know too, to be careful what they say on the phone. Otherwise, they are going to listen to you. Now let me think if there's anything else I wanted to tell you. I think that's mainly it. One of the main things though you need to do is document everything that happens from the very beginning. As soon as you know something has changed that's unusual, like your password being changed for your bank account or your credit card, that's pretty serious. There's no reason either to get a new credit card number or change your bank account. I mean, you can do that, but chances are they're just going to hack into it again. All you can do is change your password, see if there's any other security measures at your bank and your credit card or anything else can be used. Now, something really great that you can do is do not use yahoo.com. It is the worst email that can be hacked so easily. And once it's hacked, it won't even let you change your phone number. It won't let you close the account. There's nothing you can do. You just lose that account. What you really want to do is Gmail. If you do Gmail, what will happen is you can do two-step verification where they have to call you or send you a text with a code that will let you go on. Now, you know, maybe they've hacked your phone. So they're getting the code first and they're going in and they're going to change it before you do. So you never seem like you can get control of it, but you can. What you want to do is generate code numbers. That means when you don't have your device, which is your phone, you can type in these codes. So Gmail gives you a lot of opportunities to get back control of your account, your email. So that's what I highly recommend. Now there's a couple more things you can do. If you don't want them to see the history of what you're doing while they're not hacking you, but before they get back on, you know, they can look at your phone log, they can read your texts, you know, they can pretty much see where you've researched on the internet, if you've used your phone. What I highly recommend is when you're done with a text, erase it. When you've done with an email, erase it. When you have looked things up on your phone, as soon as you're done, erase the records. Don't keep anything on your phone that lets them know anything you're doing, but the one thing they will be able to do is listen to your calls and possibly record them. So just think about your calls as putting it on the TV and everyone can hear it, okay? So that's what I want to tell you with this particular part two of stalking. I will come back with part three with a little bit more information, but the main thing you need to do right now, again, like I told you in part one, do absolutely nothing, no reaction. You may, like I said, you could change your passwords and all of that, but just remember, you know, they're probably going to hack into that. So prevention again, put some extra security on all your accounts if you can, and that's it. Prevention, and just do not react when something does happen. Don't let them see that they're getting to you. Just keep on living your life, because chances are they're never really going to ever do anything severely to you because they're cowards. And they just want to psychologically hurt you and make you look terrible, you know, like discredit you to other people. So that's only if you react and let them get to you. Just be happy, live your life, and eventually they're going to go on to another victim, hopefully. So that's what my message is to you today. And document anything suspicious. And I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for listening. I really, really care about you, and I want to make sure you don't have to ever suffer through being stalked or hacked. So thank you, and have a great day.